massive job losses loom for university workers. Some of the lecturers are trained in courses that currently have no students, and that could be scrapped altogether. On page 6, the story continues, and it appears there are so many courses in public universities that have no students at all. For example, and they've listed these universities, University of Nairobi has 57 programs that out of those, the ones that have more than 10 students are only 10. That meaning that the rest, about 47 or so, have less than 10 students. Some have none. Surely, this is a waste of resources. Is this the situation in universities?
Well, I think what we need to take into account is the manner in which the education system and sector over the last 10 years has in a way been reviewed, but sometimes not with the correct aspect, because I think we had put so much emphasis on expansion of universities. And I think if you recall, they came to a point where we were thinking we would like to have institutions of higher learning in every county, and the focus was really in terms of numbers. And in as much as we thought about getting to introduce quality, in my view, there wasn't as much effort placed in looking at the overall environment that gives students confidence. Because if you check the private universities, you'd see that there seems to be a much tighter watch at looking at the needs and seeking to relate and link students' skills and courses to the work environment. I know, for example, I'm on leave of absence from USIU. I taught at the University of Nairobi before that, and I was a graduate of Kenyatta University, so I've kind of got this broad eyes view. And one thing that I could see from USIU, the United States International University, was this continual effort not only to have a broad-based program that introduces students to strategies for life skills broadly, but also to connect the programs that are in the major different schools, business, psychology, you know, health sciences, to the workplace. So I think what I would suggest is that it is necessary taking into context this trend to get back and now say we have the universities, we have courses, but we don't seem to have students. What is the issue? And I believe that lecturers are very versatile. I am trained in linguistics and African languages. Yes. I taught courses on intercultural communication. I've taught courses on research methods, critical thinking, and I really would be able to handle a number of other areas. So I think the way we need to handle this is to put on hold the concern we had about numbers and get back to looking at these programs and then look at how it is that we can deal with the catchment, the students, and then tailor the very programs as they exist. They can indeed be revised or tailored so that they can tack the students' connection between theory, abstract knowledge, and application in the real world. Because I think that's what students really seem sometimes to be looking
for. I've seen in other jurisdictions, Senator, that some universities look focused, especially when you look at a university like Harvard. The first thing that comes to your mind is law. Many lawyers coming out of there, they focus a lot more on that. I'm sure they have other courses, but they seem to specialize more on legal studies as well. Don't you think that probably that's where Kenyan universities should try to, that's something they should try to emulate? Because it appears each and every public university we have is trying to have every other program, some of them not necessary, probably in that region they are domiciled, and that could be the problem. 57 programs at the University of Nairobi, only 10 have more than 10 students. It means that all the other 47 are not necessarily that attractive to people in that area.
I agree with you that it has reached a point where our universities should specialize, such that if it is University of Nairobi, we should have specific specialization that they are having, and looking at maybe JKUAT, KU, Mo University, they can be aviation among others. Now that we are expanding, which is important, that now we have more universities than ever before. We are seeing also counties, and there was a law that was passed some times back in the last parliament that assisted in setting up of the universities across counties, which is very important because when you want to empower a nation, education is one of the important sectors. But the problem we have, and I agree with Prof now that she's talking out of experience, is that it should be market driven, because some of the courses that are offered look archaic, because when you talk about some of the courses that do not even need it, like for example bachelors of sand, bachelors of soil science, or some aspects that do not meet the market driven. So the university should not concentrate so much on on expansion, and I think it should be stopped, so that we have universities concentrating on the core mandate, on the quality.
Yes.
Because the issue, the most employers, and I think there was a report last year, most employers are complaining that the graduates that we churn out are not competent enough to meet the market needs and market demands. And where we more theoretical, and I think the reforms that we are seeing in the education sector has tried now to come back to emphasize on more practical aspects. And therefore you find some of the employers now are more comfortable employing somebody from diploma and certificate rather than employing the same person with bachelors. And therefore the university should stop, I agree with Prof, on the issue of running around of expansion, but they should concentrate more on quality and specialization. And I think also on this aspect, I have seen the headline, although it related with the first phase X, some of these universities, we have to admit that they have become tribal cocoons, where everybody wants, if a university is set in for example, in Ukambani or Machakos, the visitor should be a Kamba. Therefore, you get almost 80% of the staff come from the same locality, which is, it is good, but we should agree on the basis that NCIC has given us. But on the programs that we should look at market demand, we should look at those aspects that drive our economy, so that we ensure the people who graduate are the people that meet the particular standards and the market needs, so that our employers do not need to struggle so much trying to employ somebody. And then the problem finally is that in this country is very interesting. Sometimes you will find a graduate in bachelor's of education working as a banker. We should agree, and then we should also agree for specialized. You will find somebody has bachelor's in education, master's he has in MBA economics, PhD he has in soil science. So there is a lot of confusion that we are walking around that is dangerous, because such a person, which specialization will have? That is the point. We should agree that let us also grow a specialization in this country. And that is why finally when you look, I think that is my final, when you look at vocational, you saw CS yesterday said most people are avoiding going to TVET. And I think with the backdrop of this, we should encourage more students to go to TVET, so that we can have vocational training and technical skills, which will drive the economy that we have.
And that has been made very clear, the fact that there's no specialization in our schools, and probably TVET was to sort that out. But that wasn't the situation a few years back. JKUAT, for example, even in its name, it was Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. Yet right now you may find that because it has over 90 programs, I'm sure those 90 programs, more of them, majority of them have nothing to do with agriculture and technology. And probably that's a problem. That probably, I've seen that at the University of Nairobi, where different schools placed differently, separately, the School of Education in Kikuyu, the School of Agriculture elsewhere. Probably that's how, that's how universities should be, that that School of Education in Kikuyu should have been a university focusing on education. KU a few years back was mainly known for churning out teachers. Now it's teaching everything.
Well, it is something very broad, Fred. Apart from the courses to be market oriented, there is also the concept of university education. In the past, if somebody had university degree, it was almost a guarantee that your future is already taken care of. And therefore the other courses, like even diploma, certificate courses, were ignored. And this has created almost everybody wanting to have university degree. And with it is also the question of capitation of various university programs, especially public universities. Therefore, universities have been forced to go for courses that were lucrative, that they would get money so that they can run other programs. This has also created courses that may not necessarily have long-term benefit to the university or to the nation. And therefore, where the rain started beating us is where we failed to ask ourselves, what is the market requirement and how many students are we churning for per program, so that we tailor the number of graduates coming out to the number of needs that are there in our society, including, of course, the need to amplify entrepreneurship, so that when I get university degree, it doesn't mean that I have to get to a classroom. I can also go to the market and try to be an entrepreneur, do a few things here and there. Finally, also, there is also need for us to think beyond the borders of Kenya and see some of these courses, are they attractive to some students in Africa or other countries, so that we feel, because we have the facilities. You find some of these courses, if you are told for 7 courses don't have adequate number of students, ask yourselves, are there no students in Zambia? Are there no students from Rwanda? In one of the courses I'm taking, I have about 5 students who come from Africa, and many of them yearn to come to do these courses, but at times the fees has been also an impediment, where those from Kenya are paying, let's say, 80,000 per semester, and those from other countries until recently are paying slightly more than that. And this is really important for us as a nation, and let's not run away from the reality. The other issue is also the conditions and terms of service of university staff. We say we are churning out graduates who may not be able to do certain jobs, but what is the work environment for the staff of the universities, especially in public universities? Mm-hmm. And some of it has nothing to do with money. It has to do with the reality that if I'm teaching at the University of Nairobi, I need to be housed either by the university or to be given adequate accommodation, so that I don't really live in slums where some of the students' scripts might disappear in the process of running away from floods that may be arising. And this should be seen in the context that we are addressing the long-term issue of giving Kenyans shelter. If a university don't like her has some good shelter, it's almost guaranteed that even our children will inherit from her. But if university don't have a way they can even get mortgage for a car, mortgage for a house, however modest, it can be a house that may cost like 7 million, but give them opportunity to get these mortgages. So it is a cluster of things that we cannot unravel in a press conference like this, but it is important that our education system is relooked. Finally, I'm sorry I've said finally twice, is the issue of those who fall by the wayside, those who are diploma or certificate holders. Are we really preparing them so that in various constituencies, in various counties where there is now money, whoever is a mason there must have basic certificate, so that we don't have buildings that are going to collapse in the next 20 years, because this is what is happening in many counties, in many constituencies, and this is something that as government we ought, or as a people of Kenya, we ought to look at this particular sector.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, the headline on the Standard reads, massive job losses loom for varsity workers. Some of the lecturers are trained in courses that currently have no students, and that could be scrapped altogether. The story is on page 6, and they've actually listed all the 31, 32, 38 universities, including the public constituent colleges, about 6 of them. With programs, and those that have less than 10 students. For example, and this is the situation because they're talking about the number of lecturers vis-a-vis the number of programs. Mm-hmm. The 57 programs at the University of Nairobi, only 10 have more than 10 students, yet the number of staff stands at 4,946. Mm-hmm. And that's why we're saying that in the near future, some of these staff members could be axed.